Dorrance Publishing Company presents Jesus on My Shoulder, The Life of a Police Officer, by Sergeant Dennis R. Sands. Digitally narrated using the voice of Todd Robertson. Introduction. I've walked the walk, so I can talk the talk. This book is dedicated to all of the public supporters of law enforcement. These true events may be considered unbelievable, but they actually did happen. Every citizen, every police recruit, and every person considering a career in law enforcement should be exposed to the life of a police officer so they can answer the question, what would I do if? Each day as a police officer is different than any day before. If you are on the job, you must be mentally and physically ready for what comes next. It may be a day when you are bored. It may be a day of routine calls, such as traffic accidents or minor reports. But someday there will be a day that after what happened on your shift, you cannot go to sleep that night. I guarantee it. The stories that you are about to read are true stories. Each one happened. All happened in DeKalb County, Illinois. Some of the stories may be hard to believe. A few are funny. A few are unbelievable. A few are downright nasty. But they are a story about the life of one police officer, Sergeant Dennis R. Sands. Now, I am not a religious fanatic. I was baptized, confirmed into the church, and married in a church, but throughout my adult life, I rarely went to church. Years after I retired, I woke up one night from a dream about some of my police encounters, which I often did. Why? I asked myself, half asleep. Why could I get a dangerous call, or find myself in a crucial or totally unexpected situation, and always, and I mean always, have a sense of calmness and confidence that I can handle it? Reflecting back on my career in that moment, it suddenly dawned on me. Maybe, just maybe, there was a reason for why. I had never thought this way before that night. Without my realizing it, I had had a helper on my shoulder all along in my career. I woke up completely with an amazing story to tell. I had the answer to why. Now I also had a title for a book, Jesus on My Shoulder. Welcome to my story. I hope you find it entertaining, constructive, and inspirational. My daughter Becky has been after me for years to write a book about the police stories I had told her, and now I have finally answered her request. Please put yourself in my shoes. What would you do if? Chapter 1. Machine gun fire in a county forest preserve. It was a cool fall afternoon. Everything was quiet and peaceful. I was on patrol in my squad car, Zebra 12, and I decided to drive through the Sanok Forest Preserve in southern DeKalb County to look at the fall foliage. Sometimes during hunting season, we got deer hunters who illegally chased deer out of the preserve into open fields. Often unarmed hunters would bang sticks against trees to illegally chase the deer out of the preserve. Then they could legally shoot them. So I was on alert for any nearby gunfire. As I drove around a curve in the road and down a small hill, I was shocked to hear automatic gunfire. I immediately stopped to figure out where the distant gunfire was coming from. I radioed dispatch about the gunfire and my location. The gunfire was coming from the east of me. There is a small creek that flows through that area. I got out of my squad car. As I walked down the hill, I heard a second burst of gunfire. I recognized this as being from an automatic weapon like a machine gun. I updated dispatch, and they notified both the Sominok and Sandwich police departments, each 5 to 10 minutes away. They had backup coming. There were no county squad cars within 30 miles. I was able to jump from tree to tree, down to the creek area. Then another burst of machine gun fire. Peeking around the tree I had just jumped behind, I was able to zero in on the exact location. It was on a tree-lined hillside on the other side of the creek. I could see two people, a man and a woman, and a pickup truck. Both subjects appeared to be in their early 20s. Seeing that they were on the other side of the creek, I backed up, hustling from tree to tree to my squad car. I notified the two city backup cars that gunfire was from the east side of the creek. we would have to approach the offenders from the east through the local airport property. They should meet me at the airport entrance. I met with the Samanok and Sandwich units and filled them in on what I saw and heard. They both said at the same time, "Now what?" I had that sense of calmness. I knew what I needed to do. First, I needed to reduce their stress. I confidently described my thoughts and plan. They would back me up with loaded shotguns. I joked with them about not shooting me. Nothing reduces tension quicker than a laugh. I could see both were now relieved and relaxed. They were confident in the plan and ready to execute it. We left our cars out of sight and got up to the tree line. We noticed there had been no more firings. As we moved singly from tree to tree, we could see their pickup truck. One more factor to consider. There was a large dog panting in the truck bed. We could see the driver's door was open. There was a pair of legs extending out the doorway. Obviously, the couple was preoccupied with each other. This was the big break we had hoped for. But how was the dog going to react? As I approached the truck, the two officers had their shotguns pointed and ready. The dog just looked at me with his tongue out and tail wagging. I was able to walk right up, my gun drawn, to the open door and shout, "Police! Do not move until I tell you to move." Both of their heads popped up, but they lay still. I sternly said, "I have two officers with me, and they have shotguns pointed at you." I ordered the male to slide out first. One of the officers immediately handcuffed him. The other officer handcuffed the female as she slid out. The dog remained calm with his tongue out. The male admitted the gun was his. I told him machine gun.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.